Alright, so what's it called? We're at Goma, and so I'm like on a daily thing. We're trying to do like these like little ZBrush battles. I'm trying to get back into a swing of things, so I'm here with Brian. And
What's up?
You're not on the screen, so
perfect,
because we don't want to scare people. So we're on ZBrush right now. This is what's it called? I'm trying to get back into the thing, like I said. And right now, let me show you some of my references. So today's battle is we're gonna do aliens, based off of we're doing stuff based off of H.R. Giger's work, and yeah, so check it out, and we'll post this up in just a little bit. So, all right, shut up, Google. All right, and yeah, so this is we're doing a 30-minute.
Sure.
So we're doing a 30-minute battle. So hey, Google. Turn on a timer for 30 minutes.
Sure, 30 minutes, starting now.
Okay, cool. And yeah, we'll see what we come up with. Hey Google, play some music based off of DJ Shadow.
All right, here's DJ Shadow entering
computer's really sticky. It's not good. I'm gonna turn off some stuff. I'm gonna restart this thing. So I'm just waiting, but no. We do these battles just to keep our skills up and just, you know, kind of doing our thing. Try to keep it interesting. Try to keep talking. I don't do these videos very often, so I'm trying to get in the habit of doing them. There we go. Now this is a lot better. Okay, cool. So, I'm still trying to, like, figure out if I do, like, this, what's called the new ZBrush. It has a lot of cool things in it. So right now I'm gonna just start making an alien. So today's topic is basically anything alien based, right? So or alien or slash H.R. Giger ish. So yeah, I mean I saw the new movie. It's pretty cool. The new Sculptress brush, which I kind of did right now. There's a lot of cool stuff. Basically, if you see, it makes more tessellation here, so that I can keep on sculpting. So what we have here is we got some teeth, we got some goes. Let's move this in. So, you know, before you start getting into this kind of stuff, it's really good to study some anatomy. I had some really great teachers over there. Some of you guys know me as an artist here in Atlanta, but it wasn't until, like, you know, getting into this kind of line of work that, you know, I understood. I have a really big appreciation for those who do anatomy and, you know, study sculpting and all this stuff. I find design now is like, you know, you find great pieces of it everywhere you go. It's pretty cool. I find it just really neat. Alright, let's see. So right now I'm gonna mask this bottom part out, right? Because I need some teeth, some gums and shit like that. So I'll take this, I'm gonna go to subtool, I'm gonna go to extract. Let's track this on accepted. So what it does is makes another subtool right here. And now what I have is somewhat of something I can work with right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just if you notice, I really stress this with everybody that, you know, that I try to teach ZBrush to, is that go ahead and know your tools very, very well. What's outside the box is just not, it's not the best, it's not the greatest. So you kind of want to kind of make it your own, right? So we have this alien thing right here, it's bulbous. On top has like this weird freaky, you can almost see the skull, and it comes out here. We have cheekbones that come out right here, you can see that, and then it comes down to here and has what's it called, it has the chin bone right here and strong jawline. So we just gonna put this in here and pop this here. Basically the neck kind of starts on here, so I'm going to get this onto the lasso tool. Let's see, I'm going to pull this out. And dynamo, she said. Just want to put more definition. Cool. And here. Ooh, a little high. Let's take this down just a bit. So right now I'm just going to decimate my mesh. Take it down to 88. So now you can see it's a lot lower. It's about 88,000 polys now. And now it's even lower, so that works for me. I can work with this. And I'm just dynamish it. Oh, whoops, don't dynamish that. Let's go to. Don't work with this. Cool. So, yeah, ever since. What's it called? ZBrush introduced dynamish, it's been such a game changer. I gotta say though, I'm really, really impressed with with some of the new additions that they've brought on to ZBrush. It's quite pretty amazing. I'm not gonna do a whole character today just because I already can tell this is not gonna be a cute model, but whatever. I'll do the best I can. With bust, maybe if I do have time, I'll try to make a skeleton, but not right now. I'm getting some like nice details and stuff like this. Let's go to there's a way to do it, to get this to do it again, but whatever. Right now I'm just... a little clown face. Not the best demo ever. We'll get through it. Generally, I like to actually make subgroups, so you see I just did that, so there's a new subgroup right there. Thank you. I always have reference up. So I think it's really, really crucial to have that shit up, just because the best reference is like real life. There's no doubt about it. It's just amazing that, you know, you can have a world like, you know, all this shit, and then what's it called? There's just so much alien shit out here that I just find pretty fascinating. But you'll look at something and like, oh, that reminds me of something else. So I do find it very, very helpful. So the physiology of this alien is basically humanistic qualities. It looks like its ribcage kind of extrudes it, so there's like something like it comes out to the back right here. The ribcage dips down, comes down to here. The chest kind of a little bit too much. The highest point from the chest is like right here. It's a good indicator to like, you know. Back of this thing looks like, but I'm guessing because it's an HR Geiger creature that it's going to have it's going to be really spiny, right? I know this is going to sound terrible, but a great reference is, what's it called? I actually have a huge reference of just what's it called, different body types and stuff. A lot of this stuff is based off of, like, you know, shit that we have in our minds already, right? These gaunt, skinny things is what really, really terrifying. Believe it or not, though, it's like, reference from, like, different types of, like, you know, walks of life, or, like, you know, things of, like, you know, anorexia, stuff like this are actually good references for skeletal structure. It's not something that I'm not condoning or anything in any which way, but it is, there's great references for that kind of thing. Okay, Google, how much time do we have left on the skull? Okay, Google, how much time do we have remaining? here. And my computer died. I swear, I'm just trying to make a video. I just feel like all this stuff happens when I'm like, you know, timed on something, and then I also have like, you know, just a million things happening at once. It's kind of shitty, but whatever. So I have that up there just for reference, and I'm going to basically I don't have a really like the greatest picture here, but it looks like his legs are really, really long. So here, and then I'm gonna go here. Unified skin, preview it, just make it, type preview it, I'm just gonna go for it. Z-Series on this. So there it is, it's a nice booty. Right here. We're gonna go ahead and append this right here. So we have this right here, and clear this out. I'm gonna go ahead and append. Wrong one. Getting into ZBrush, I strongly recommend you making your own custom, what's it called, UI, because you know, doing something through like different mad different like a number of programs and stuff. Yeah, just really. Oh, another thing is, I know this is kind of funny, but yes, definitely most people don't like working on the crotch area. Work on the crotch area because things that have no crotch, it looks really weird. It's just not right. Let's move. So another good point of reference is looking at the silhouette of a creature, making sure that it's looking good. I just pushed V for that. I'm going to look at my reference, and let's look at the reference right here. So right here we see that this this thing is down here. It almost comes like back to the back of his what's it called square back of his rib cage. So I'm going to come back up here and make this a little bit longer. And his rib cage ain't that big. You see? Now that you know, I'm actually watching this stuff. I'm being very very careful about it. I'm getting proportions just a little more to where I want them to be. The new Tesame brush is pretty badass. Like I said before, Dynamesh was a big help. I mean, that was a huge game changer. Huge. I can't even tell you how much of a game changing thing that was. That really changed the flow for a lot of stuff that we do. Say a Tesame brush, I'm learning to like it. So apparently Sculptress now is his own thing, and I didn't know what direction they were going to go with it, but I had to say, like, I think they did a great job with it actually. How time do we have left for the sculpt?
We've got 2 minutes and 1 second
remaining. 2 minutes.
2 minutes. This is not a great sculpt. So let me get in just the high detail areas right now so I can actually make it look a little kind of cool, right? I just had a lot of bugs and issues doing this one. Okay, Google, stop. Give it a, what's it called? Give it 5 more minutes. I'm giving myself 5 more minutes just because my computer's been sucking.
I don't think you can need to explain that to Google.
No, I'm explaining to the live broadcast I'm doing right now. I just want to get the peek in. Is that cool, Brian?
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah.
I know you're down. I was like, I'm down with that shit. Okay, Google. 5 minute, what's it called? Make a 5 minute. Google, play the next song. Google. Hey, Google. Play the next song. Alright, we're gonna stop. Okay, Google. Stop the timer. Alright, so this is what I got in 20 minutes, but I'm not gonna lie, it's not the best, but whatever. I was trying to get into more high detail stuff. Oh, damn, Brian. Looks like we won today.
Oh, that looks good. Damn, that looks good too. Damn. Shit.
It's getting there.
Yeah, I think it looks really good. The anatomy's looking good. Scale.
It's getting there. And yeah, that's it today. So what's it called? I'll post these up on our website. What's it called? If you want these files too, I'll send a Z tool if you do ZBrush, and so you guys can mess around with whatever I've been building out. So yeah, cool beans. And yeah, I'll post up Brian's thing too as well. All right, peace out.